Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today we are going to see addressing mode part 3. Okay, we already explained immediate addressing, register addressing and direct addressing. Now let us see the next one, how to access data from the RAM using register indirect addressing. You have to listen carefully because it is a bit confusing. What is register indirect addressing? You are taking a data to the register from a memory location whose address is given in a register. For example, here I am writing move A comma at the rate of R0. Now suppose R0 contain 40, that means move A comma 40. That means whatever data available in 40 will go to A. Suppose after that you are writing increment R0, now R0 become 41. Then if you write move A comma at the rate of R0, the data from memory location 41 will go to A. So in summary, move A comma at the rate of R0 means move the content of RAM whose address is stored in the memory, address is stored in register R0. Now let us see the next example. Move at the rate of R1 comma B. The data available in B will go to a memory location R1. Memory location pointed by R1. For example, R1 contains the data 30. The data in B register will go to the memory location 30. That is the concept. So that is why this is known as register indirect addressing. Register indirect addressing means data you can move from memory location to a register. Normally the memory location will be pointed in a register R0 or R1. Okay, that is the concept of register indirect addressing. Now let us see some example. Now what is the question here? Write a program to copy the value 55H into RAM memory location 40H to 41H. Now we already studied direct addressing mode. Now let us see how to do this one using register addressing mode and register indirect addressing mode. Okay, now let us see the first one. Move A comma hash 55H. 55H will go to A. Now A contain 55H. Move 40H comma A means 55H will be going to the RAM location 40H. Move 41H comma A means 55H will be going to 41H. So you are copying the data from the accumulator to 40H and 41H. The same program can be written using register indirect addressing. Now this example B, what we are doing, 55H is going to A and R0 is stored with the data 40H. Here hash sign is there, that means 40H will go to R0. Now move at the rate of R0 comma A means A contain 55H, 55H will go to the memory location 40H. Increment R0. What is in R0 now? R0 is 40. Increment R0 means R0 is 40 plus 1. So R0 is 41. Move at the rate of R0 comma A means 55H will go to 41H. So this program is direct addressing. What it is doing? 55H is copied to memory location 40H and 41H. And this is also doing the same thing. 55H is copied to 40H and 41H. But here we are doing it using register indirect addressing. This is register indirect addressing. This is register indirect addressing. Now imagine you want to copy 55H to 25 location. Then if you want to write using register indirect addressing like this one, it will be easy as compared to direct addressing. If you are using direct addressing, what you have to do, move a comma hash 55h, then move 40h comma a, move 41h comma a, move 42h comma a, move 43h comma a. Like that you have to write 25 instruction for each location. So it will be very time consuming. Now, if you are using register indirect addressing, we can ask the microprocessor to repeat these two instructions. What is these two instructions? Move at the rate of R0, comma A and increment R0. Suppose you want to copy to 25 location, we can ask the microprocessor, repeat this one. For that, we are using the third technique with a loop. So now look here. To two location we have to copy. So what you are doing, move a comma hash 55h, move R0 comma 40h, move R2 comma 02. Now this R2 is known as a counter. Now move at the rate of R0 comma a means 55h will go to memory location 40h. What is R0 now? R0 is increment R0 means 41. Decrement jump on non-zero R2 again means R2 is the counter, R2 is 1. So it is not 0, so again it will go here. So this process will be repeated. How many times? 2 times. Now suppose you want to copy to 25 location, what you have to do? Just write here 25. The program is so simple. So that is the advantage of register indirect addressing. So what is the basic difference between direct addressing and register indirect addressing? If you are using direct addressing, you cannot repeat a group of instruction. Using register indirect addressing, you can repeat group of instruction again and again. So that is the basic difference in application for direct addressing and register indirect addressing. So I already explained looping is not possible in direct addressing mode. Now look here. The same thing. Now we are repeating the example so that you will get more clear concept. Write a program to clear 16 RAM location starting at RAM address 60H. So clear A. Accumulator is now 0. Move R1 comma 60H. R1 got 60. Move R7 comma 16. What is R7? R7 is a counter. Okay. Now move at the rate of R1. What is in A now? In A, there is 0. So 0 will go to memory location 60H. Increment R1. R1 will become 61. Right? Now decrement jump on non-zero R7 again. So R7 was 16. Now it is 15. Again it will go. Now by the time R1 is now 61. So 0 will go to 61. Increment R1. R1 became 62. Decrement jump on non-zero R7. R7 again decreased by 1. So it was 15, now it is 14. So this process will be repeated 16 times. So when the program finishes, what is the value of R7? The value of R7 will be 0, because when R7 is 0, it will come down. Is it clear? And what about R1? R1 will be 60, 61, 62. Like that, it will be incremented 16 times. That you have to remember. Okay? So that is the concept. So in the assessment, I may ask a program something like this, and I can ask you what will be the value of R7 after finishing the program. What is the value of R1? Okay. Now, for example, put here, let us make here a small example. R7 is equal to move R7 comma 03, and I'm putting here 60. So first, what will be R1? 60 to 60 A will go. Increment R1, what is the value now? 61. Decrement jump on non-zero R7. R7 was 3, now it is 2. Okay, again it will go. It is now 62. So the data will be going to 62. Like that it will be repeating. Okay, so in this way you can find the value of R1, R7, etc. Okay. Now, how can you copy a data of 10 bytes from one memory location to another? Okay, so what we need, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39. Starting from 35, 10 consecutive memory locations are having some data. We want to copy that to a memory location starting from 60. we already performed this one in the lab. So this explanation will give you more clear concept. So what is here? Move R0 comma hash 35 H. R0 got 35. Move R1 comma 68. R1 got 60. Move R3 comma hash 10. R3 is now 10. Right? So here 10 is in decimal. This both 35 and 60 are in hexadecimal. Move A at the rate of R0. So from memory location 35, the data will be going to A. Now what is R1? R1 is 60. So the data from memory location 35 is copied to A. From A, it is copied to memory location pointed by R1. What is in R1? 60. So the data will be going to memory location pointed by R1, means it is going to 60. In summary, the data from 35 will go to 60 memory location through the accumulator. After that, what we are doing? We are incrementing R0 and R1. So R0 became 36 and R1 became 61. Okay. So now from 36, the data will be copied to 61 through the accumulator. So this process will be repeated till R3 becomes equal to 0. It will come down. So when you finish the program, what is the value of R3? The value of R3 will be 0. Okay, next one is indexed addressing mode. Indexed addressing mode is the only method used for accessing the data from the read-only memory. So you have to remember, there is only one technique to take a data from the read-only memory. Read-only memory is also known as code memory. That is why when we are writing move instruction for transferring a data from the ROM, we will normally write move C. C means code memory. Okay, move C A comma at the rate of A plus DPTR. DPTR is a 16-bit register. The current value of A will be added. For example, DPTR is 200. And suppose A is 0. So 0 plus 200. So now this is ROM location 200. The data from the ROM location 200 will go to A. Okay. Suppose A is 5 and DPTR is 200. 200 plus 5, 205. From the ROM location 205, the data will go to A. Okay. And you have to remember, DPTR is a 16-bit address. A can have any value from 00 to FF. Now, more details about indexed addressing mode will be explained in the next video. Thank you all.